Can you still sing that?
Dale! Dale! There's one or two there.
Are you still proud of that, or do you wish you'd never sung the damn thing?
I'm glad I sung it. Are you kidding?
Because that was one of the greatest...
Every time I go to the Yankee ball game, and I hear in the middle of our... any inning, all of a sudden there's... Dale!
Really?
And 60,000 voices go, Dale! I said, I made it. There was no validation.
What I didn't know was that was obviously off the Banana Boat song. It released in 1956... But the album Calypso became the first album to sell a million copies.
First in the history of the industry.
Isn't that amazing?
Yes, it is.
And that can never get taken away from you. That was huge in those days.
Yes, very much so. In those days, we didn't have internet and Facebook and all those things. It was really almost mouth to mouth, word, country to country, border to border.
What are your personal other favorite songs?
Try to remember a great ballad from the Fantastics. Mm. A lot of the calypsos that I did were filled with metaphor. I sang a lot of songs that came out of the classic English tradition. A lot of Irish songs. Yeah. Danny Boy.
Danny Boy, of course.
I remember I was in Africa in the midst of the We Are the World campaign during that great devastation, and I ran upon a group of Irish nuns, and they were out there feeding the hungry and really doing incredible work. And I sat with them that night around the campfire. And one of the nuns said to me, Harry, could you give us a little song? And I said, gladly. And he said, "What? Could you lead us in your version of Danny Boy?" And here I am sitting in Africa, in Kenya, with all these nuns singing Danny Boy.
Oh, amazing.
It was a very touching moment.
It's a fabulous song, when sung by you. I'm Irish, but when I sing it, it's not quite as magical, I have to say.